Jill Murphy, and I am the president of Project Guild of LaGrange, and I would just like to welcome you all here to our annual grand luncheon for the Grand Marshal this year. This year, I know all of you probably know, but we're here to celebrate the amazing Bobby Stess. And we are so very glad that all of you could join us today in celebrating her. At this time, I would like to ask Reverend Derek Robinette to come give our invocation.
Thank you. I want to celebrate Bobby today as we pray. And I've been blessed to be Bobby's pastor for the last 2 years. And one of the things that I learned as I became the pastor at Crestwood United Methodist, where two or three are gathered, Bobby is there. And she's taking a picture, and she's sending an email, and she's making sure that we're leading well and making a big difference. And she always says, let's be the hands and feet of Jesus. And one of the things we know about the hands and feet of Jesus is God always does immeasurably more than we can ask or imagine. And as we go to God in prayer, let's pray that blessing over each of us, but also pray the blessing over all the ministries and different community action that Bobby helps to lead, because we know that blessings in a backpack are going home on Friday, and God is going to do immeasurably more than we can ask or imagine in the life of those kiddos as they receive those blessings. So thanks, Bobby, for how you serve Jesus. Let's pray together. Amazing God, we thank you that we get to gather together as a community and to celebrate people that are your hands and feet in the community. And God, we do thank you for Bobby Stess. God, we thank you for the many people that she influences, like her family. And we thank you for how they make a difference in the groups that she leads, like Rotary and the Interchurch Council and other groups, and how they make a difference in the community. And God, we know that you are blessing so many people right now. And God, we thank you that we get to be a part of that. God, we pray that you to bless this food to the nourishment of our body, that it may give us the energy to continue to follow you. And God, as we follow you, we trust that you are going to take the efforts that we give, and you're going to do the work that you need to do in the lives of the people that the efforts touch. For it's in Jesus' name we pray, and all God's people said, amen. Amen.
Thank you for that. We are ready to start lunch, but before we do that, I just want to say thank you to our entertainment, Ron and Nancy Cheek, for entertaining us as we all came in and as we all go to get lunch. So if at this time I could ask Bobby and the head tables to start our line, and then her family can follow after her, and then I will announce who is next. You can go ahead. Yes, I'm sorry. I forgot to give you instructions. So we would like to enter in this door to get your food, and then you will exit to the lobby and then return to your seat.
No, I'm not gonna be alive.
thank you again for the wonderful music as we are getting our lunch today. We appreciate it. So we will get started. We have a great program for you all today, some great speakers, while you all enjoy your lunch. But first, before that, I would like to thank a few of our sponsors who sponsored our luncheon today, and that is Baptist Health LaGrange. Thank you. Stockyards Bank and Trust, and Insurance Associates. And I would like at this time to ask Caroline Mina and Jay Hall if they would like to come up to say a few words.
Thank you, Jill, and thank you to Project Guild for inviting Stockyards Bank and Trust to participate today. We have been sponsoring this event, or co-sponsoring, for the last several years, and are always really excited when we get the call from Mary Broker inviting us to be included today. Again, my name is Caroline Mina. I'm a senior vice president and wealth advisor with Stockyards Bank and Trust Wealth Management, and those of you do not know, Stockyards was established in 1904. We started doing banking for individuals, families, and small businesses, particularly those in the agricultural business and who are in the Butchertown area of downtown Louisville. Well, since that time, 119 years, we now have 73 branches, three of which are in Oldham County, LaGrange, Crestwood, and Goshen, and we're proud to be part of this community and working with those of you here. If you're customers of Stockyards Bank and Trust, we thank you. If you are not, we welcome you to give us a try. Our cornerstones of our business are community and personal service. So today, we're especially excited to honor Bobby Stess, who has spent her adult life giving back to her community and providing charitable services to those in the community with great need. We congratulate you on being named the Grand Marshal of the 2023 Oldham County Day Parade and wish you the best. Thank you.
Thank you, Caroline. Jay is on his way.
Thank you. I'm Jay Hall with Insurance Associates. We don't have near as many branches as Stockyards. But next month, I will celebrate my 45th year in the insurance business in Oldham County. And I have want to say from Insurance Associates, this will be about my only advertisement, if you have a need for personal or commercial insurance in 45 years, we've probably seen it, and if we can help you with any issues, we would love to do that. Over 45 years, what I have seen is a lot of Oldham County Days and a lot of Oldham County Day parades. And I have known most of the members of the Project Guild. With that said, I was given the opportunity last year to be the lead sponsor of the parade. That was an easy decision. Insurance Associates is honored to be involved with Project Guild and a truly great organization of community-minded ladies that help promote Oldham County and have improved the place we call home for 59 years. You know, in one respect, Project Guild is just like all other organizations. Fiscal court judge, I know you're out there. City council, Mayor Black. Civic clubs. All the organizations, planning and zoning boards, I thought to think about what do they all have in common? They're only as good as the members that make them up. And we all know the members in Project Guild are outstanding in this community. On that note, I will point out one difference, though, between all those other organizations. Project Guild is made up of all ladies. Lastly, I want to say, if you know Bobby Stess, you know what a worthy person she is of the honor of Grand Marshal. Project Guild, you've done another outstanding job in choosing Bobby, and I look forward to another fabulous Oldham County Day. Thank you.
Thank you, Jay. I would now like to introduce you, our speakers for this afternoon's program. Speaking today will be Dr. Blake Hazelton, Jessica Fleischer, and Nick Stevens. Dr. Hazelton, if you would like to start.
Thank you very much. I normally don't do these speeches and introduction, the comments, until the day before or morning of. And as I got into writing this one, there was a lot there. So if I miss anything, I apologize, but there are some things that we just can't miss. First thing I want to say is thank you to the Project Guild for Oldham County Day, and also for co-hosting this luncheon today with the LaGrange Rotary Club. I got a nice note from Mary Broker, who was the chair of the, or is the chair of the luncheon today, providing some guidelines, and one indicated that you would appear for 5 minutes. Now, those of you who ever heard me speak before know that I have a hard time staying within a 5 minute limit. And I'll tell an interesting, but probably the only story I'll have 5 minutes to tell. And that is that when I first became superintendent of schools in Oldham County, I was invited to the annual dinner of the Liberty Alumni Club. And this was from Liberty Consolidated K-12 school. And they had graduates, and they'd come back and meet. But fortunately, unfortunately, Liberty is closed and we're getting ready to demolish it. But I went over and I was greeted by the group at the front of the room when you sign in. And a lady came up to me, took me aside. She said, "Now, I want you to understand why you're here." And I said, "I think I know why I'm here. I'm superintendent of schools and I want to bring greetings and talk about what's going on in the school district." And she said, "Well, I just have to tell you that our last speaker last year spoke over the limit. And that's why you're here." So I want to encourage you, don't exceed the limit today. And I said, "Well, you know, give me a high sign when I'm getting close and I'll just stop right there." And so that was a wonderful group of people. They have pretty much all died off in that period of time. I don't know any of the alumni that we talked to or I talked to during that period, but they're a delightful group and very loyal, and also I think left a legacy in our community. So one other thing you have to realize as you get a little older is your vision is not as good as it was at one time. I was privileged to work with Bobby Stess in the school district for about 30 years. I'm honored to make comments about her today. She was a teacher leader at Crestwood Elementary and in the school district. And I think that sometimes we miss that when we have teachers that just go above and beyond at the school level, what contributions they make at the district level to make the school district what it has been and what it is. She served on the executive committee of the Oldham County Teachers Association and is president of that association. And she and OCTA were significant factors in the success of the schools. And I want to mention, although probably shouldn't until they're having something like this, but Rhonda Hale and Sally Sheely were two others that were involved in that worked very closely with Bobby and, again, made the district a little bit better. How? There were several things that came to mind. We used to co-sponsor the district and OCTA an opening day engagement where we toured the district on buses in those specific school districts. center field, go in the center field district and ride around and see where are your kids coming from. And that's always an educational experience, but especially with new teachers and a new community. And also did it with their schools. They co-sponsored the teacher retirement dinner, which was held at the end of the year for teachers who were retiring, and also was an opportunity for our retired teachers to come back, as well as all of our faculty and staff throughout the district. And it was a packed event, and probably because it was a free meal. But I also had several retired teachers say, don't have that event end after dark, because we don't want to be out on the roads running around. So it always started about 5 o'clock, and we tried to get them out at 9. One significant challenge to that was teachers who were retiring, who were there, were asked to come up and say a few words about their experiences. And some of those were the most enlightening experiences that we have heard of or seen or didn't know about in the school district. I saw Lucy Ricketts here earlier. Is she still here? Is she hiding over there? Okay. Well, Lucy, I'm not going to tell them my story about you from Andrew's second grade experience at LaGrange Elementary School. I will just say it was a well-received story and very much appreciated by the group that was there, and was transformational, I think, at LaGrange Elementary School the next day. They also established scholarships for all three high schools, $1,000 each, for a future educator. Students applied for these, and then at the teacher retirement dinner, they got up and spoke about why they wanted to go into education. And that was just really inspirational, I thought, to the group that was there, as well as the retired teachers that didn't. And those are all things that just don't happen by accident. The final thing that I'll mention as an example was the day in Frankfort. And at one point in time, we had a crisis in Frankfort with teacher health insurance. And there were legislators were being presented with a plan to change retirement insurance that had some significant changes. And there was a big, big turmoil in the district about that. Joyce was shaking her head. Now she's nodding her head. She now remembers it. And we decided that we were going to call off school that day, along with a number of other districts, and go up to Frankfort while the legislators were there. And the Board of Education, thankfully, provided the buses for us to do that. And we loaded up about 20 buses with teachers and staff and drove up to Frankfort in the morning and came back in the afternoon. Now, one thing that I thought of when I realized that was important was we did get the insurance benefits to sustain themselves, and we did send a message that teachers would be engaged with the legislature when they had legislation that impacted them. But the other thing that I think is important, and this is one educational piece, I always feel like it's important to put an educational piece out there, is that that was an unpaid day for teachers. The general public thinks, gosh, we have a snow day, teachers are off. And they are off, but they're not paid for that day. They have to make that day up. So you extend the school year whenever you take a day off. And that was, I think, a level of commitment that most people weren't aware of, and also the difference that people can make when they have a voice. Community service, a few examples of that. I think Crescent United Methodist Church and her involvement, engagement, leadership there in that community is significant. The food pantry that she continues to promote on her Facebook page and also helps lead. She's continued to expand the Thanksgiving and Christmas baskets that her and Barry started, not started, but sustained and increased and I think expanded. And her husband, Bill Potts, and their kids, grandkids, her sisters, her in-laws, the Hacks and the Westbrooks, we're cheering down here in the front, are all a big part of what sustains her as a leader. And then finally, how close am I to 5 minutes?
I'll just keep talking.
Okay. Yeah. You're liking this, aren't you?
I'm liking
yeah,
it.
Okay. she's a leader who recognizes others. And several examples of that was she was one of the key people responsible for raising funds for the Ann Stevens Gazebo. Ann Stevens was a native of Oldham County, a teacher at Crestwood Elementary School. a wonderful, blunt, direct OCTA member who never hesitated when I went down and visited the school to let me know what she thought. And the other was Holly Fink, who has a bench down there. And Holly was just a wonderful teacher, reading teacher, writing teacher. Many of you have had experiences with her. And she's no longer with us, which is unfortunate. And then also, she's been heavily involved in Rotary Students of the Month at South Oldham and getting those kids at Rotary and getting the recognition. And I think that means a lot to kids when they come and do presentations. They seem to like that at LaGrange Rotary, and we get a lot of positive feedback on that. I'm going to conclude now by saying that I think Bobby is a role model, so much in her personal standards and personal life, her family engagement and family support, the community engagement that you've heard a little bit about here and you'll hear more about from the other two, and then her work life was exemplary. By her efforts, many others who never knew her will benefit from her efforts, and those whose lives she touches will impact others. So a number of people that are going to have an impact from Bobby's test don't even know her. It's the people that she's touched, just as ministers do and just as our leaders do in the community, that's important. It's a lesson we can all benefit from. Congratulations, Bobby, for this well-deserved recognition.
Hi. I'm really nervous. I'm sorry. I'm Jessica Fleischer. I met Bobby about 2 years ago when I started as the Family Resource Coordinator, and we became fast friends. She welcomed me into this community with open arms, and I could tell right away that we had the same vision for kids and families in this community. She had a lot of energy, and I was wondering if I could even keep up with her. Now Bobby and I spend a lot of time together, so I'm going to talk about a few things that we do together. So Bobby was a founding member of the Family Resource Advisory Council, which hired me initially. She continues on this council today, and we meet 5 times a year to discuss what programming we will put on through the Resource Center at both of the schools that I serve. Throughout the year, she collects donations of items that are needed to run the Family Resource Center, such as school supplies, coats, snacks, clothing, and other basic needs. Bobby does things large and small. Every year, Bobby and the Crestwood United Methodist Church have a Crestwood School prayer walk before school starts for the first day of school. Members the night before school take sidewalk chalk and draw really nice, fun things so that it's an added excitement for the kids when they come to school on the first day of school. One of the largest projects was getting Crestwood United Methodist Church to adopt Crestwood Elementary's Blessings in a Backpack program so we could completely revamp the program there. Bobby and I had a vision, and she made it happen. She was able to secure the funding needed to support the program. We now send home on average 30 individual bags of food to Crestwood students every Friday to help supplement their meals for the weekend. Bobby orders all the food used for those bags. She purchases additional items to add. She packs them all, delivers them to the schools. Well, I'm built too. She also collects the food for these families for all of the large school breaks throughout the year. Those large orders are delivered by members of the Rotary, and also the families pick them up. This helps these families supplement because students are home during those breaks. Bobby is the definition of caring and action because it's exactly what she is doing every day, all day. She is a true community philanthropist who has dedicated her time, energy, and resources to making a difference in the lives of the children and families within our community. She has had a profound impact on the community, touching the lives of many.
Good afternoon, everyone. Bobby Stess, the many things that I could say. Bobby.
Remember, my mother's here.
So I was told 3 minutes, not five. So We'll see. You took two of mine, so that's fine. That's fine. My name is Nick Stevens. I'm the current and past president of the South Oldham Rotary Club in Crestwood. Bobby has been an active member of the South Oldham Rotary Club for almost 8 years. From the moment she joined, she has embodied the spirit of Rotary. Service above self is natural to Bobby, about as natural as her draw. In the midst of a global pandemic, when no one else wanted the job, Bobby stepped up and became the president of our club. Never wavering from her commitment to fellowship, she made sure that everyone had the opportunity to see each other virtually or in person every single week. Once her term was over as president, she stepped up again to become the club services chair and still pours her heart into that passion to this day. She has brought many initiatives to the club throughout the years, which has provided an opportunity for Rotarians throughout our district to serve. The South Oldham Rotary Club's commitment to education and to hunger would not be possible without Bobby's leadership. Along with her commitment to serve others, she is also committed to uplifting others. She brings a loving energy to our club that is so genuine and contagious. Her contagious energy is one of the reasons why I joined the club 5 years ago, and I say thank you for providing the opportunity for me to be a Rotarian. And now I have the opportunity to not only call her a Rotarian, but also call her my friend. I found a poem as I was going and searching through, like Bobby would have written, but Kate Summers beat you to it. Too often the world is full of only about me. Others need to help, and if only I would be. More generous and caring for others, realizing at the end of the day, we are all brothers. We all have time to help another, rather than looking the other way and taking cover. It may be money, it may be time, it all helps, if only a dime. There is such a need in this world today to lend a helping hand in certainly a way. We could give back instead of being greedy. The world is full of people who are needy. Many times it is not their fault where their life is under assault. And you never know when the day will come and when you'll need a helping hand and some. So while the times are good for you, consider others in all you do. Open your eyes and lend a helping hand. There is much we can do and so much demand. You will find blessings come back to you and feelings of thankfulness will be true. You will impact the lives of others in a way that you may not realize, but please help today. I will tell you that is Bobby Stess and that is caring through action. Thank you, Bobby.
Thank you all so much for those wonderful words. Couldn't be more well said. At this time, I'd like to invite Jean Marie, who is a Project Guild member and our Oldham County Day Chair, to join me.
Thank you. Hello. Thank you all for coming today. Bobby, are you feeling honored?
Very.
I just want to take a minute and thank everyone for coming and mention our sponsors. This is truly a community event. Oldham County Day was started by a group of ladies that now there are 18 of us that put on Oldham County Day and organize it, from the Grand Marshal Luncheon to all of the things that happen on Oldham County Day. And we couldn't do it without community partnerships. And you can see on the slideshow and in your program all the different sponsorships from community groups and companies that help us make this day a success. Also, the ladies wearing shirts like me that are around here today are the Project Guild members, some of us, and so if you get a chance, tell them hello. Yeah. At this time, I would like to give a gift to Bobby to commemorate this day. If you would like to come on up here, I will give you the gift, and then you can say a few words if you would like. This is a Louisville stoneware platter to commemorate
your special day.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. You want to hold it?
Yes.
Thank you so much. Thank you to the Project Guild. I feel so blessed to have my family here, my mama, my sisters, my brother, my kids, my grandkids, my Rotary friends. But this is such an honor. I love Oldham County. I came here in 1977 with Barry, and this has been my home. I was taught a long time ago to give back. My mom and daddy taught me to give back. My grandparents taught me to give back. My nanny, my great aunt Bobby, and Mary Gardner, who was not my family, but in 1988, she won this beautiful award 35 years ago, and it's in my home because I'm her adopted daughter. And Granny always taught us to take care of people. And if you have the way and the means to do it, to do it. So you can do it large, you can do it small. But I am just honored to be here. I'm excited about the parade because I love a party and a parade. My grandchildren will be riding with me. Bill will be driving the red Mustang. And Granny had a red Mustang when she was in the parade. And my daughter Jackie and my son Patrick rode in the car with her. So we're going to repeat that with our red Mustang convertible. And I don't know how we're all going to get in there. We'll look like a clown car, but we'll have fun. But thank you for all that you all do, because I know there's a lot of people in this room who do stuff all the time helping people. And I just have had a lot of opportunities through school and church and Rotary. So do something for somebody. Help somebody out, because there's always people who need a little bit, and you get more out of it than they do. So thank you. I love Oldham County. I wouldn't want to live anywhere else.
Thank you. Again, I would just like to say thank you to all of you for joining us today to celebrate Bobby. I know a lot of you all are on your lunch break, but what better way to take lunch than to celebrate this wonderful lady? I know a lot of you have to leave, but I do have a few announcements to make before you head out, if possibly. First off, I hope all of you can join us on Saturday. There's a lot of fun activities going on. To start the morning off, the Rotary Club will be hosting their annual pancake breakfast. That starts at 7 a.m. and goes until 10 a.m. If you need tickets, see Jane Cobble. They're waving them. So I think I was told, correct me if I'm wrong, if you purchase them today, you can get your tickets for $8. If you wait to get them Saturday, they're $10. So if you don't have those yet, see her and get your tickets for the breakfast. After you enjoy your pancakes, join us. The parade will start at 10 a.m. And then the rest of the day, we have a lot of entertainment and booths for you all to enjoy. So hope to see you all out there.